Hello student, welcome in Department of Nanoscience and Nanotechnology F.Y.B.Sc. class. In today's lecture, we are going to learn about the phase diagram. First of all, we will see the definitions and basic concepts. First, components. Components are pure metal and compounds of which an alloy is composed. Solvent represents the element or compound that is present in the greatest amount on occasion. Solvent atoms are also called as host atoms. Then solute. It is used to denote an element or compound present in a minor concentration. Then what is system? It has two meanings. First, system may refer to a specific body of material under consideration, or it may relate to the series of possible alloys consisting of the same components but without regard to alloy composition. Then solid solubility. For many alloy systems and at some specific temperature, there is a maximum concentration of solute atoms that may dissolve in the solvent to form a solid solution. That is called the solute solubility. The addition of solute in excess of this solubility limit results in the formation of another solid solution or compound that has a distinctly different composition. Then what is phases? A phase may be defined as a homogeneous portion of a system that has uniform physical and chemical characteristics. Every pure material is considered to be a phase. So, also is every solid, liquid and gaseous solution. Then phase equilibrium. Equilibrium is another essential concept. It is best described in terms of thermodynamic quantity called the free energy. Free energy is a function of the internal energy of a system and also the randomness or disorder of the atoms or molecules. A system is at equilibrium if its free energy is at a minimum under some specified combination of temperature, pressure and composition. In a macroscopic sense, this means that the characteristics of the system do not change with time but persist indefinitely, that is, the system is stable. A change in temperature, pressure and composition for a system in equilibrium will result in increase in the free energy and in a possible spontaneous change to another state whereby the free energy is lowered. Then, equilibrium phase diagram. Much of the information about the control of microstructure or phase structure of a particular alloy system is conveniently and concisely displayed in what is called a phase diagram, also often termed an equilibrium or constitutional diagram. Many microstructures develop from phase transformations, the change that occur between phases when the temperature is altered. This may involve the transition from one phase to another or the appearance or disappearance of a phase. Phase diagrams are helpful in predicting phase transformations and the resulting microstructures, which may have equilibrium or non-equilibrium character. Equilibrium phase diagrams represent the relationship between temperature and the composition and the quantities of phases at equilibrium. There are several different varieties, but in the present discussion, temperature and composition are the variable parameters for binary alloys. A binary alloy is one that contains two components. If more than two components are present, phase diagrams become extremely complicated and difficult to represent. Then, binary isomorphous systems. Possibly, the easiest type of binary phase diagram to understand and interpret is that which is characterized by the copper-nickel system, as shown in figure. Temperature is plotted along the ordinate and the abscissa represent the composition of the alloy in weight percent and atom percent of nickel. The composition ranges from 0 weight percent nickel on the left horizontal extremity to 100 weight percent nickel on the right. Three different phase regions or field appear on the diagram? An alpha field, a liquid L field, and a two-phase alpha plus L field. Each region is defined by the phase or phases that exist over the range of temperatures and compositions delimited by the phase boundary lines. The liquid L is a homogeneous liquid solution composed of both copper and nickel. The alpha phase is a substitutional solid solution consisting of both copper and nickel atoms and having an FCC crystal structure. At temperatures below about 1080 degrees Celsius, copper and nickel are mutually soluble in each other in the solid state for all compositions. This complete solubility is explained by the fact that both copper and nickel have the same crystal structure, that is FCC crystal structure, nearly identical atomic radii and electronegativities, and similar valences. The copper-nickel system is termed isomorphous because of this complete liquid and solid solubility of the two components. The line separating the L and alpha plus L phase fields is termed the liquidus line, as indicated in figure A. The liquid phase is present at all temperatures and compositions above this line. The solidus line is located between the alpha and alpha plus L regions, below which only the solid alpha phase exists. For figure first, the solidus and liquidus lines intersect at the two composition extremities. These corresponds to the melting temperatures of the pure components. For example, the melting temperature of pure copper and nickel are 1085 degrees Celsius and 1453 degrees Celsius respectively. Heating pure copper corresponds to moving vertically up the left hand temperature axis. Copper remains solid until its melting temperature is reached. The solid to liquid transformation takes place at the melting temperature and no further heating is possible until this transformation has been completed. For any composition other than pure components, this melting phenomena will occur over the range of temperatures between the solidus and liquidus lines. Both solid alpha and liquid phases will be in equilibrium within this temperature range. For example, upon heating an alloy of composition 58% nickel, 58% copper, melting begins at approximately 1280 degrees Celsius. The amount of liquid phase continuously increases with temperature until about 1320 degrees Celsius, at which the alloy is completely liquid. Then, interpretation of phase diagrams. For a binary system of known composition, the temperature that is at equilibrium, at least three kinds of information are available. First, the phases that are present. Second, the compositions of these phases. And third one is the percentages or fractions of the phases. The procedure for making these determinations will be demonstrated using the copper-nickel systems. Then determination of phase compositions. The first step in the determination of phase compositions is to locate the temperature composition point on the phase diagram. Different methods are used for single and two phase regions. If only one phase is present, the procedure is trivial. The composition of this phase is simply the same as the overall composition of the alloy. For example, consider the 68% nickel and 48% copper alloy at 1100 degrees Celsius. At this composition and temperature, only the alpha phase is present, having a composition of 68% nickel, 48% copper. For an alloy having composition and temperature located in a two-phase region, the situation is more complicated. In all two-phase regions, one may imagine a series of horizontal lines, one at every temperature. Each of these is known as a tie line or sometimes as an isotherm. These tie lines extend across the two-phase region and terminate at the phase boundary lines on either side. To compute the equilibrium concentrations of the two phases, the following procedure is used. First, A tie line is constructed across the two-phase region at the temperature of the alloy. Second, the intersections of the tie line and the phase boundaries on either side are noted. Third one is, perpendiculars are dropped from these intersections to the horizontal composition axis from which the composition of each of the respective phases is read. Next is lever rule. The relative amounts of the phases present at equilibrium may also be computed with the aid of phase diagrams. Again, the single and two-phase situations must be treated separately. The solution is obvious in the single phase region since only one phase is present. The alloy is composed entirely of that phase, that is, the phase fraction is 1.0 or alternatively, the percentage is 100%. From the previous example, for the 60% nickel, 48% copper alloy at 1100 degree Celsius, only the alpha phase is present, hence the alloy is completely or 100% alpha. If the composition and temperature position is located within a two-phase region, things are more complex. The tie line must be utilized in conjunction with a procedure that is often called a lever rule, which is applied as the tie line is constructed across the two-phase region at the temperature of the alloy. The overall alloy composition is located on the tie line. The fraction of one phase is computed by taking the length of tie line from the overall alloy composition to the phase boundary for the other phase and dividing by the total tie line length. The fraction of the other side is determined in the same manner. If phase percentages are desired, each phase fraction is multiplied by 100. When the composition axis is scaled in weight percent, the phase fraction computed using the lever rule are mass fractions. The mass of a specific phase divided by the total alloy mass. The mass of each phase is computed from the product of each phase fraction and the total alloy mass. In the employment of the lever rule, tie line segment lengths may be determined either by direct measurement from the phase diagram using a linear scale, preferably graduated in millimeters, or by subtracting compositions as taken from the composition axis. Consider again the example shown in figure, in which at 1250 degrees Celsius, both alpha and liquid phases are present for a 35% nickel, 65% copper alloy. The problem is to compute the fraction of each of the alpha and liquid phases. The tie line has been constructed that was used for the determination of alpha and L phase compositions. Let the overall alloy composition be located along the tie line and denoted as CO. And mass fraction will be represented by WL and W alpha for the respective phases. From the lever rule, WL may be computed according to WL is equal to S divided by R plus S. Or by subtracting compositions, WL is equal to C alpha minus CO divided by C alpha minus CL. Composition need be specified in terms of only one of the constituents for a binary alloy. For the computation above, weight percent nickel will be used, that is, CO is 35 weight percent nickel, C alpha is 42.5 weight percent nickel and CL is equal to 31.5 weight percent nickel. So, substituting the values we will get WL is equal to 0.68. Similarly, for the alpha phase, W alpha is equal to R divided by R plus S or it is equal to CO minus CL divided by C alpha minus CL. Substituting again all the values, we will get W alpha is equal to 0.32. Thus, the lever rule may be employed to determine the relative amounts or fractions of phases in any two-phase region for a binary alloy if the temperature and composition are known and if equilibrium has been established. Next is Gibbs phase rule. The construction of phase diagrams as well as some of the principles governing the conditions for phase equilibria are dictated by laws of thermodynamics. One of these is the Gibbs phase rule. proposed by the 19th century physicist J. Willard Gibbs. This rule represents the criteria for the number of phases that will coexist within a system at equilibrium and is expressed by the simple equation that is P plus F is equal to C plus N, where P is the number of phases present. The parameter F is termed the number of degree of freedom or the number of externally controlled variables which must be specified to completely define the state of the system. Or expressed another way, F is the number of these variables that can be changed independently without altering the number of phases that coexist at equilibrium. The parameter C is the number of components in the system. Components are normally elements or stable compounds, and in the case of phase diagrams are the materials at the two extremities of the horizontal compositional axis. And N is the number of non-compositional variables. Let us demonstrate the phase rule by applying it to binary temperature composition phase diagrams, specifically the copper-silver system, in which pressure is constant, that is 1 atmosphere, the parameter N is equal to 1, which is temperature, and number of components, that is C, is equal to 2. Then by substituting the values, the equation becomes P plus F is equal to 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3. That means F is equal to 3 minus P. Consider the case of single phase fields on the phase diagram. Since only one phase is present, P is equal to 1. And therefore, F is equal to 3 minus P, that is 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2. This means that the completely describe the characteristics of any alloy that exists within one of these phase fields. We must specify two parameters. These are composition and temperature, which locate respectively the horizontal and vertical positions of the alloy on the phase diagram. For the situation wherein two phases coexist, for example, alpha plus L, beta plus L, alpha plus beta phase regions, the phase rule stipulates that we have but 1 degree of freedom, since F is equal to 3 minus P, which is equal to 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1. Thus, it is necessary to specify either temperature or the composition of one of the phases to completely define the system. For binary systems, when three phases are present, there are no degree of freedom. Therefore, F is equal to 3 minus P, that is 3 minus 3, that is equal to 0. This means that the compositions of all three phases as well as the temperature are fixed. Then, construction of phase diagram. For the construction of phase diagram, the most common used method is thermal analysis. When a graph is made of temperature against time at constant composition as shown in figure, this method is used for determination of solidification. The resulting cooling curve is shown a change in slope. Figure shows a series of cooling curve for various combinations or alloy between metal A and metal B. Each cooling curve is a separate experiment starting from zero time. The cooling curves for pure metal shows a horizontal line because the beginning and end of solidification takes place at constant temperature. Next is solubility of sugar in water, that is sugar water phase diagram. Figure shows solubility curve gives the idea of solubility limit of solute in solvent. Solubility of water as all sugar dissolve in water, which forms liquid solution, that is syrup. All composition to the left of curve are in one phase. The higher percentage of sugar shows the right of the curve. It is impossible to dissolve sugar completely. Hence, the mixture is of two phases, that is solid sugar plus liquid or syrup is obtained. X-axis indicates the percentage of sugar left to right and from right to left percentage of water. So, total components must be 100%. Another example of solid solubility is sodium chloride and water phase diagram, that is NaCl in H2O. This is the another example of solubility limit, that is NaCl water phase diagram. The liquid solution is called brine, which is shown in figure. Solubility limit increases with temperature. Beyond this limit, there is a region of liquid plus solid. The solubility limit of NaCl decreases with temperature. Then, types of phase diagram. There are three types of phase diagram. First one is components completely soluble in liquid and solid state. Second is components completely soluble in liquid state and completely insoluble in solid state. And third one is components completely soluble in liquid state and only partially soluble in solid state. So, first one is copper-nickel phase diagram, that is type 1 phase diagram. This copper-nickel phase diagram have been already discussed in binary isomorphous system. The copper-nickel system is termed isomorphous because of this complete liquid and solid solubility of the two components. Next is type 2 phase diagram. This phase diagram can be developed from series of cooling curves. Actual phase diagram constructed by plotting temperature against composition in weight percent. Point M and point N are the melting point of two pure metals are plotted on vertical lines. The upper region is liquid solution. MEN is liquidus line and shows the beginning of solidification. The point at which liquidus line intersect is known as eutectic point E. And the composition corresponding to eutectic point is eutectic composition, that is 40A60B. It is common practice to consider alloys to the left of the eutectic composition as hypoeutectic alloys and those to the right as hypereutectic alloys. The solidus line is always a continuous line connecting the melting points of pure metals. Hence, MFGN is a complete solidus line. This phase diagram consists of four areas. The area above liquidus line is a single phase liquid solution. The remaining three areas are liquid plus solid A, liquid plus solid B, and solid A plus solid B. The composition 40A60B is a eutectic composition. It is cool from the temperature, remains a uniform liquid solution up to the point E is reached because this is the intersection of liquidus line. That is, the liquid must start to solidify and the temperature cannot drop until alloy is completely solid. The change of liquid of composition at point E into two solids at constant temperature, it is known as eutectic reaction. Next is type 3 phase diagram, that is lead tin, which is also known as eutectic phase diagram. Figure shows the type 3 phase diagram, that is PBSN phase diagram. In this, eutectic temperature TE is 183 degrees Celsius. Composition of liquid CE is equal to 62% SN. Composition of alpha, that is equal to C alpha E, is 18% tin. And composition of beta, that is C beta E, is 97% tin, that is 3% lead. PBSN is an example of this phase diagram as shown in figure. There is complete liquid solubility, so liquid phase extends over all compositions. The liquid phase at left end, there is a lead which dissolves limited amount of tin. Solubility decreases with decrease in temperature. This limit is indicated by phase between alpha and alpha plus beta, which is called as solvus. The phase boundaries are given below. Liquidus 1, which is boundary between L and L plus alpha region. Liquidus 2, which is boundary between L and L plus beta region. Solidus 1, which is boundary between alpha and L plus alpha region. Solidus 2, which is the boundary between beta and L plus beta region. Solvus 1 is the boundary between alpha and alpha plus beta region. And solvus 2 is the boundary between beta and alpha plus beta region. Two phase regions are separated by horizontal line corresponding to temperature TE. called eutectic temperature. Below this temperature, material is fully solid. At eutectic temperature, L gives alpha plus beta, and this is the reverse reaction. The eutectic temperature TE, CE, C alpha E and C beta E are all fixed. Then Al2O3, Cr2O3 phase diagram. Here, two components dissolve in each other in all proportions, both in liquid and solid states. The two components must have same crystal structure. Pure Al2O3 and pure Cr2O3 are present at the end of composition axis. There are only two phases on phase diagram, that is liquid and solid. Single phase regions are separated by two phase region, that is L plus S. In all binary phase diagrams, a two phase region separates single phase region. As we move from single phase region, then we cross into two phase region and again into solid phase. The phase boundary between liquid and L plus S region is called liquidus line. The boundary between solid and two phase region is called solidus line. When only one phase is present, the composition axis gives composition of that phase directly. At temperature T, horizontal line called as tie line. The points of intersection of tie line give liquid and solid composition, that is Cl and Cs, that are in equilibrium with each other. Hence, T is equal to 2180 degrees Celsius for an overall composition. Here, CO is equal to 73% Cr2O3. Liquid composition Cl is 57% Cr2O3 and solid composition Cs is 82% Cr2O3, that means 18% L2O3. If we specify the composition of one of the one phase, the temperature and the composition of other phase are automatically fixed. Their solid solubility is limited in binary system, but it is not zero. The microstructural changes that occur on cooling and overall composition, CO, is shown in diagram. Above the liquidus material, there is a single phase. On cooling, we cross the liquidus line and enter into phase region at temperature T. Solid crystal of composition CS coexist with Cl. Then, binary eutectic systems. Another type of common and relatively simple phase diagram found for binary alloy is shown in figure for the copper-silver system. This is known as binary eutectic phase diagram. A number of features of this phase diagram are important and worth nothing. First of all, three single phase regions are found on the diagram, alpha, beta and liquid. The alpha phase is solid solution rich in copper. It has silver as a solute component and FCC crystal structure. The beta phase solid solution also has an FCC structure, but copper is a solute. The alpha and beta phases are considered to include pure copper and pure silver respectively. Thus, the solubility in each of these solid phases is limited. In that, at any temperature below line BEG, only a limited concentration of silver will dissolve in copper, and similarly for copper in silver. The solubility limit for the alpha phase corresponds to the boundary line labeled CBA between the alpha and alpha plus beta and alpha plus L phase regions. It increases with temperature to a maximum at point B. The decreases back to zero at the melting temperature of pure copper point A. At temperatures below 779 degrees Celsius, the solid solubility limit line separating the alpha and alpha plus beta phase regions is termed a solvus line. The boundary AB between the alpha and alpha plus L field is the solidus line, as indicated in figure. For the beta phase, both solvus and solidus lines also exist, HG and GF respectively as shown. The maximum solubility of copper in the beta phase point G also occurs at 779 degrees Celsius. This horizontal line BEG, which is parallel to the composition axis and extents between these maximum solubility positions may also be considered to be a solidus line. It represents the lowest temperature at which a liquid phase may exist for any copper-silver alloy that is at equilibrium. There are also three two-phase regions found for the copper-silver system, alpha plus L, beta plus L, and alpha plus beta. The alpha and beta phase solid solutions coexist for all compositions and temperatures within the alpha plus beta phase field. The alpha plus liquid and beta plus liquid phases also coexist in their respective phase regions. Furthermore, compositions and relative amounts for the phases may be determined using tie lines and the lever rule. As silver is added to copper, the temperature at which the alloy becomes totally liquid decreases along the liquidus line, line AE. Thus, the melting temperature of copper is lowered by silver additions. The same may be said for silver. The introduction of copper reduces the temperature of complete melting along the other liquidus line FE. These liquidus lines meet at the point E on the phase diagram, through which also passes the horizontal isotherm line BEG. Point E is called an invariant point, which is designated by the composition CE and temperature TE for the copper-silver system. The values of CE and TE are 71.9 weight percent AG and 779 degrees Celsius respectively. An important reaction occurs for an alloy of composition CE as it changes temperature in passing through TE. This reaction may be written as L of CE gives alpha C alpha E plus beta C beta E by cooling, and this reaction is reverse. Upon cooling, the liquid phase is transformed into the two solid alpha plus beta phases at the temperature TE. The opposite reaction occurs upon heating. This is called a eutectic reaction, and CE and TE represent the eutectic composition and temperature respectively. C alpha E and C beta E are the respective compositions of the alpha and beta phases at TE. This is the binary eutectic system. So, in this chapter, we have been seen definition and basic concepts of phase diagrams, then construction of phase diagram, types of phase diagrams, determination of phases, interpretation of phase diagram, and binary eutectic system. Thank you very much.